Hello friends, this is Sharmila and welcome to my kitchen. Today I'll be making three types of dosa. Before start making dosa, I want to share some tips that can help you to make perfect dosa every time. Number one, always use non-stick tawa and keep this pan aside, specially for making dosa. Frequently used pan always have a chance to stick. Number two, greasing is not so important if you have good quality non-stick tawa. You can directly put the dosa batter in and make dosa. If you want to grease, then take a potato slice, dip in oil and grease the pan like this. You can also use brush, stem of brinjal or lauki, or even onion slice. Now we will be making three types of dosa. So here is my dosa batter ready. I have not added any salt earlier as it does not help in growing yeast. So now add salt, and the batter is also too thick, so I'm going to be adding 1/2 cup of water to make it pourable consistency and mix it well. First I'm going to be starting with plain ghee dosa. First heat the dosa tawa. Make sure it is moderately hot. If your pan is too hot, you can't spread the batter center to outward. It will set in the center. Put a spoonful of batter in the center of the pan. Now using back of the spoon, move the batter from center to outward till the edges of the pan. Now allow to set it. I hope you are able to see many small holes in the upper surface. In those pores, drizzle some oil or ghee. The pores will absorb the oil and help it to cook well. Don't try to release the corners of the dosa with the ladle. Give this some time. Once it will cook well, the dosa will leave the sides by itself. And see, it starts leaving the pan. This dosa doesn't need to turn to upside down. And its bottom side also become nice and golden brown. Ekdom khub sundor badami rong hoye geche. So my perfectly thin dosa is done and serve with coconut chutney, spicy red chutney and sambar. Next I'll be making classic masala dosa, which is the best dosa ever, and this is the most ordered dosa in the food stores. Make sure the pan is not too hot. Put a ladle full of dosa batter center of the pan and carefully rotate it in a circular motion from center to the corner. Spread some tikki chutney on the dosa for extra deliciousness. Now put masala in the center. Spread a little bit. See, I have not added any oil yet, but still the dosa released the pan. Though the pan was greased with little bit of oil earlier. Amazing, na? Now fold the two sides of the dosa and this is ready. Now I'm going to be making tasty onion dosa. Pour a ladle full of dosa batter in the center of the pan. Now using back of a spoon, swirl the batter from center to outwards in a circular motion. My dosa batter is so good that even though the pan is hot, it is spreading so nicely and become thin. If you can make it thin, your dosa would be crispy for sure. Now drizzle oil or ghee or butter in the pores. Add onion and coriander on the dosa. Cook for one more minute. Now the bottom surface turns beautifully golden brown and the edges start to release the pan and come upward. Spread a little bit. Serve this onion dosa with red chutney, coconut chutney and sambar. So here I got three beautiful dosa, plain dosa, masala dosa and onion dosa. Oops, how can I bind up this session without giving you the recipe for masala dosa? But before that, make sure you subscribe to my channel to watch some more awesome flavorful dosa recipe. Like this video, share this video and put your comments below how it came out. And also let me know if you want to get the recipe of red chutney, coconut chutney and sambar that I served along with dosa. Till then, take care and bye. To make aloo masala, we need 2 potatoes boiled and mashed, 1 big onion chopped, 1/4 teaspoon turmeric powder, salt to taste about 1/3 teaspoon, 2 to 3 chopped green chilies, 2 tablespoon chopped coriander, 1/2 teaspoon coriander powder and red chili powder. To temper the oil, we need some raw chana dal and urad dal, 2 red chilies, 13 to 14 fresh curry leaves and mustard seeds or sarson ka dana or shoshe. We also need peanuts. Heat some oil. Temper this oil with all the tempering ingredients like chana dal, urad dal, red chilies, curry leaves and mustard seeds. Saute for a few seconds until they become nice golden brown. Now add chopped onion, salt, turmeric powder and chopped green chilies. Saute till onions become soft. Now add roasted peanuts. Just saute well. Now add coriander powder, red chili powder. Add 1 teaspoon water to prevent burning of the masala. Saute again. Next add mashed potato. Keeping the heat low, mix well with all the spices. Now add chopped coriander. Saute again. That's it. Our easy and quick dosa masala is ready. Now enjoy it with dosa. It also tastes good with rice or roti.